Happy Monday, Piper Middle School. Today is Monday, May 17th. We hope everyone had an excellent weekend. I'm Alyssa Minnick.
And I'm Michaela Brick. Here are the announcements for this week. Even though spring sports have concluded, we want to take this opportunity to celebrate the success of 7th grader Allison Oaks. Allison tied the middle school girls' high jump record with a jump of 4 feet 10 inches at the Clark Invitational. Phenomenal work, Allison. Keep it up. As a reminder, all athletes that participated in track must return in uniforms and pick up their medals that they earned from Coach Hall as soon as possible.
If you are interested in participating in fall sports, remind your parents that you will need a new physical for next year. Also, don't forget these are numerous summer camps occurring on the Piper campus this summer. Stop in the office to pick up the interest forms. On that note, here's a quick message from Coach Pollard at the high school for any 8th grade football players wanting to play football next year.
Good morning, Pirate Nation. I'm Coach Pollard, the head football coach at Piper High School. I'm here to share some information with you. First and foremost is our Pirate Iron form to get you in the weight room this summer. There's a session for you 8th graders that are becoming 9th graders. You'll be level 2 lifters with the high school. You 6th and 7th graders that are becoming 7th and 8th graders, you'll be lifting with the middle school session. Also in the office, in your middle school office, is our summer camp form. Make sure you pick that up to sign up for summer football camp. The other things that are in there that's exciting this summer is you 8th graders, becoming 9th graders, there's a calendar of all our high school football activities. Make sure you pick that up. You can attend the camps with us. We go to Pittsburgh State for 3 days. We go to different colleges and have camps and scrimmage against other teams. That's exciting. So any 8th grader that's becoming a 9th grader that would like to play and attend those camps, please pick up that calendar. But also what's exciting this summer is our middle school for all you incoming 7th and 8th graders, so current 6th and 7th graders. We have sessions for you. We will have a practice for you every Wednesday, along with your weightlifting sessions on Monday, Tuesday, Thursday. On Wednesday, we'll have practice sessions for an hour to get you ready for the season. You'll be practicing with our high school coaches. Your middle school coaches will also be there. But you also have a camp week in there. So make sure you pick up those forms and get ready for the upcoming fall season. We're excited about what the summer brings, kind of getting back to normal, and what the fall will look like for us. It'll start to look back to what a football season should look like. So again, we're excited. Grab the forms. If you have any questions, feel free to email me at rpollard@piperschools.us, and I'll answer any questions. I can't wait to see everybody out there playing and getting excited about Piper football. Thanks.
Switching gears, the month of May celebrates Asian Pacific American Heritage Month. Please check out the display in the Commons commemorating and celebrating the generations of Asian and Pacific Islanders who have enriched American's history and are instrumental in its future success.
The Wyandotte County Health Department sponsored a poster contest to promote the spread of the coronavirus with the hashtag #IHelpedConquerCOVID. Several Piper students submitted entries, and it's clear to see that we have some Pirates with outstanding artistic abilities. We are pleased to congratulate the following winners in each category, who will each receive a prize from the WICO Health Department. 7th grader Ashlyn Worrell received 3rd place, Riley Atkins earned 2nd place, and Annalisa Lockwood got the top honor. Excellent work, ladies! In addition to her 1st place selection, Annalisa's poster advanced to the countywide competition. Finally, it's time for some swashbuckler shoutouts for students who are doing great things in the classroom.
Ms. Arndt would like to give a shout out to Evan Scruggs. Evan is always willing to help others who are struggling with the experiment. Curious and willing to jump ahead so he knows future experiments and is able to become the expert for the class.
Mrs. Bast and Mr. Smith would like to recognize Jack for always being helpful to his peers. Mr. Smith noticed Jack go out of his way to help a student who had his hands full open a door, which may sound like a little thing, but it shows a willingness to be polite and selfless. A big shout out to Jack Bakeridge, who are always being willing to help out other students. Mrs. Clark and Mrs. Cook would like to recognize Nadia Smith. She has always been a huge help serving as a P2 office aide. Thanks so much, Nadia, for your assistance.
Finally, Mr. Mercer and Ms. Bass would like to remind students to finish the school year strong. Keep those grades up, take advantage of Friday help sessions, and continue to demonstrate good behavior in the classroom, halls, and when visiting other buildings. You represent Piper at all times, so have respect, exercise safety, be responsible, and own your actions.
That's it for today. Have a great rest of your week. Here's a joke from Avery and Maya to get you started.
Kennedy, why are pirates called pirates?
I don't know, Maya, why?
Because they are.
Oh, yeah! Woo! The pirates.